Welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering subject. In this lecture, we will discuss waveguide attenuators. In this waveguide attenuator, there are two articles, resistive card attenuator and rotary vane attenuator. So this article comes under unit 5 of microwave engineering subject. Let us see what is resistive card and rotary vane type attenuator. So first let us see what is attenuator. Attenuator is a device which absorbs certain portion of the power of the wave. So what is attenuator? Attenuator is a device which absorbs certain portion of the power when the wave is passing through it. Now let us see the resistive card attenuator. The resistive card attenuator may be either fixed or variable. So there are two kinds of resistive attenuators: fixed resistive card attenuator and variable resistive card attenuator. I have shown given two diagrams for this. This is fixed resistive card attenuator. This is variable resistive card attenuator. So let us see the first one, the fixed resistive card attenuator. In this fixed version, the resistive card is bonded to the waveguide as shown in figure A. So in this, this is the resistive card. This is resistive card is fixed or bonded to the waveguide as shown in this diagram. So second one, the card is tapered at both ends in order to maintain a low input and output standing wave ratio over useful microwave band. So therefore you can clearly see that this card is tapered at the both ends in order to reduce input and output standing wave ratio over useful microwave frequency range. This tapering is also done to minimize the reflections because of this resistive card. The tapering is also done to minimize reflections when the wave is passing through it. What is this resistive card does? When the wave passes through it, it absorbs certain portion of the wave. It absorbs certain portion of the wave when the electric field is parallel to this resistive card. Let us see the third one. The maximum attenuation is achieved by having the card parallel to the electric field. So that is what we have discussed. And at the center of the waveguide, where the electric field is maximum. So therefore, in order to achieve maximum attenuation, what we have to do, the card is placed parallel to the electric field, and this card is also placed at the center of the waveguide, where the electric field is maximum. Next point, the conductivity and size of the card are adjusted by trial and error method to obtain the desired attenuation value. In order to obtain desired attenuation, the size, the dimensions of this card are adjusted in a trial and error basis to achieve the required attenuation when the wave is passing through this waveguide. So last one, in high power versions, in order to observe very high power, instead of resistive cards, ceramic type of absorbing materials are used instead of resistive cards. In high power versions, in order to observe a very high power of the wave passing through it, we use ceramic type of absorbing materials instead of resistive card. So what is the purpose of this resistive card? Which absorbs certain portion of the power when the electric field is parallel to this card. Now let us see. So this is about fixed attenuator, where this resistive card is fixed in the waveguide. Now let us come to the variable resistive card attenuator. So this is the resistive card attenuator. This is hinge arrangement. This resistive card enters through this non-radiating slot. So this is a non-radiating slot. This resistive card enters into the waveguide through this non-radiating slot with the help of hinge arrangement. The resistive card can enter this into the waveguide because through this non-radiating slot. So that's why it is called as variable resistive card attenuator. Let us see one by one. Variable resistive card attenuator. A variable version of this attenuator is known as flap attenuators. This attenuator is also known as flap attenuator. Second one, you can see the card enters the waveguide through the non-radiating slot with the broad wall, and there is by intercepting and absorbing a portion of the TE10 wave. So what you can see that this card enters into the waveguide through the non-rating slot, thus intercepting the wave passing through it and absorbs certain portion of the power when the wave passes through it. Next, third one, the hinge arrangement allows the card penetration and attenuation in the range of 0 to 30 dB can be achieved with longitudinal slot. So therefore, with this kind of arrangement, we can achieve the attenuation in the range of 0 to 30 dB with this resistive card in this kind of arrangement. The last one, none of the TE10 wave is radiated through this slot. So though it is open slot, no electromagnetic energy is radiated through this slot. That such a care is taken that no electromagnetic radiation is going through this slot. So that's why this slot is called as non-radiating slot. Now, so what is the disadvantage? The disadvantage of this resistive card attenuators are the attenuation is frequency sensitive, which makes it inconvenient to use as a calibrated attenuator. So because this both attenuators are frequency sensitive, because of this reason, these are not used as calibrated attenuators in the laboratory purpose. So these kind of attenuators are generally not employed as calibrated attenuators in the laboratories. So these are the resistive card attenuator. Simple explanation, the purpose of this resistive card is to absorb certain portion of the power when the wave is passing through it. So this is fixed attenuator, this is variable attenuator, resistive card. In fact, both are, this is resistive card and this is resistive card. This resistive card is fixed, whereas this resistive card enters into the waveguide through this radiating slot. So the penetration can be adjusted with the help of hinge arrangement. So the disadvantage is that both cannot be used in laboratories as calibrated attenuators. So this is about waveguide attenuators. In fact, exactly resistive card attenuators. Thank you.